Today on Mr. Media, I'll talk to Meaghan Rath, co-star of the new sci-fi network show Being Human. She plays a ghost sharing an apartment with a vampire and a werewolf. Stick around. I don't make this stuff up, folks.
Hey, did you know that you can listen to the latest Mr. Media on your phone with the Stitcher app? Stitcher is smart radio for your smartphone. Mr. Media is on demand and on the go with Stitcher. Download Stitcher for your phone today. Get the free download at Stitcher.com. That's S-T-I-T-C-H-E-R.com.
So much media, so little time. Who keeps track of it all? That would be me. This is Bob Andelman, and this is a Mr. Media interview. You know, MrMedia.com, MrMedia.com. Stop by and check it out. There are nearly 700 archived celebrity interviews for your listening pleasure. The show is brought to you today by our new sponsor, Star Pirates. Star Pirates is a free online sci-fi game that I think you'll really enjoy playing. Give it a try today at www.starpirates.net. You must be at least 13 to play. Again, that's starpirates.net. Mr. Media is recorded live before a studio audience of Hollywood's most famous ghosts, including the casts of Topper, The Ghost Whisperer, and, of course, Patrick Swayze, in the new media capital of the world, St. Petersburg, Florida.
Being human is harder than it looks, especially when you're different.
When you're around, odd things happen.
I'm dead.
You're a vampire of shacking up with an animal.
Should we call 911? You're a werewolf occasionally.
The whole point of this house was having one place where we can be human.
Talk to me again if you're asked.
What was that? It's channeling my inner wolf.
Being Human, an original series. All new every Monday at 9. Only on Syfy. Imagine greater.
Syfy has been on a roll these last few years when it comes to original series. Eureka, Warehouse 13, and Haven are all big hits and much enjoyed in my own household. So it was only a matter of time before the network unleashed a new concept, Being Human. In this case, the show about a vampire, a werewolf, and a ghost sharing living quarters, okay, it sounds a little silly on paper, but it comes to us with an established history. It's actually adapted from a British series of the same name. Now, starring in Being Human are Sam Witwer as the vampire, Aidan, and Sam Huntington as the werewolf, Josh. But the story doesn't really kick into high gear and show its real humanity, if you will, until we meet lovely Meaghan Rath as the ghost Sally, who died in the very apartment she now shares with Aidan and Josh. And Meaghan Rath, welcome to Mr. Media.
Hi.
Hey, nice to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
My pleasure. Meaghan, I'm thinking that when a young girl dreams of being an actress, she thinks about playing, princesses, for example, but not ghosts.
I've always been a really big believer in the supernatural, especially ghosts. So I was really excited about this.
Well, that answers the question. I was going to say, because what do you think when you're being told that you're going to play a ghost and, you can't touch anybody immediately, and there's a couple other limitations.
Yeah, it makes it difficult. To be honest, when I first, was reading the scripts and when I found out I got the role, I didn't really look at that as a big challenge, but it was only once I got on set and actually started, living with those limitations, I realized how hard it was.
Yeah.
I mean, just not being able to touch anybody or anything was really difficult. I mean, it's convenient I don't get any props, but it makes it a challenge. It makes it a big challenge because you don't have those crutches to rely on in terms of acting. You have to sort of just let the word speak for itself and the emotion speak for itself. So it makes it difficult.
Well, and as my daughter noticed, you're going to have to wear the same outfit for however long the series is on. Is that about right?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, I don't really mind it because maybe it was because I went into it knowing that I would have one outfit. But also, it's really comfortable. I feel like I'm in my PJs all the time, which is nice. But it makes sense for the character. I mean, Sally's reality is that she's frozen in time a little bit, so it just it works. It adds to everything.
Was there discussion in terms of costuming? In terms of what is this poor girl going to be comfortable in for 3, 4, 7 years? Was that an issue?
It was a huge thing. My costume is actually quite similar to my British counterpart's costume. Mm. They really liked that, so they kept it quite similar. But there were, I went through, I don't know, maybe four fittings of, you know, 4 or 5 hours at a time. You've never seen so much gray on a rack in your life. So it was just about finding the right combination and what it was. And then once it was narrowed down to about five different options, we screen tested them, saw how it looked on camera with different, you know, filters, with different lighting. So it was a huge process.
What about the other side of the costuming, in that you can't really gain any weight as a ghost for the next X number of years?
Yeah, I know. I guess, I don't know. I mean, I guess not. That'd be kind of awkward. Like, what's wrong with this ghost? Like, what's she been eating?
I mean, Kirstie Alley could not play this ghost, you know? Oprah Winfrey could not play this ghost. It'd be ballooning up and down, and there's no technical explanation. Well, you know, in the ancient book of ghosts, yeah, it wouldn't work that way.
I know. I guess I've never had more incentive to stay in shape.
All right, so Sally, as we meet her, she can't touch anyone, she can't get through the doors, but we know things will happen. I'm also guessing through maybe flashbacks, things like that, you have a little more opportunity to stretch, so to speak.
Yeah, I mean, there are a couple flashbacks, but Sally really goes on a big journey. And it's exciting because where she ends up at the end of the season is in a completely different direction from where she started, which makes it really interesting. I think for the three of us, we have these huge, massive character arcs, which makes it so exciting to play. But you're really in for some surprises.
Well, I wanted to ask you, how important is the manner of Sally's death to the continuing narrative of being human?
It's really important.
Okay.
I mean, Sally's, all her physical limitations are tied to her emotions. So she's trying to figure out why she's stuck in this, you know, in between, and where she's supposed to go and why she hasn't moved on. And so she's trying to essentially unblock something in herself. So she's trying to figure out what is it, what's the catalyst that is going to get me to this other place that I need to go to, because she knows that she's not supposed to be stuck here.
Hmm.
So, yeah.
I'm also seeing some parallels to, of all things, to Lost. Of course, the guy who played Jacob is in Being Human, but also the fact that you have to wear the same costume all the time as they did, but also this idea of being, as we found in the last episode of Lost, of being kind of in purgatory for so long.
Yeah, that's so interesting. I never thought of that. You know, I'm a huge, huge Lost fan. So I never even thought, that never even occurred to me about the same clothes or anything. But yeah, I mean, it's a drama. It's sort of, there's elements of mystery and supernatural in it. So I guess it's similar in that way.
Hmm. And last question, because I know you have to get going, but what can you tell us about each of your co-stars, the Sams? Are they good guys or are they monsters in their own right?
They're amazing. Those guys, I feel like they're my brothers. We get along so well, and we're actually all going on vacation together. We're going to Hawaii next month, so we genuinely like each other. Sam Witwer is just, he's like a life-size action figure. He's amazing. He's unbelievably talented and funny and silly and ridiculous. He's sort of like a 15-year-old boy. And Sam Huntington is just the most generous, sweetest, warmest person I've ever met. So giving and present in scenes, and it's been a pleasure to work with him.
Hmm. And did anyone else catch the other parallel, that they're going to Hawaii together, home of Lost? Okay.
I know.
Right.
I know.
Gosh. Well, folks, listen, you can see through actress Meaghan Rath as the ghost of Sally in the new sci-fi hit, Being Human, every Monday night at 9 p.m. And Meaghan, thank you so much for joining us on Mr. Media today.
Thank you for having me.
All right. Good luck to you. We'll talk soon.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Bye.
For more original interviews with your favorite sci-fi stars, surf over to our main website, mrmedia.com, mrmedia.com. Subscribe to Mr. Media on iTunes, and you'll never miss a show. Just search Mr. Media Interviews from within iTunes and subscribe for free. You can also listen with a piece of string and a tin can in many locations. If you've got an idea for a guest, a comment on today's show, or would like to advertise on Mr. Media, email me directly at bob@mrmedia.com. That's mrmedia.com. You can also follow me on Facebook or on Twitter, twitter.com/Andelman, or on Facebook, just search Mr. Media Interviews. Thanks so much for joining us today. Really appreciate you sharing a piece of your day with Mr. Media. Thanks for listening.
Hey, y'all. This is Lauren Bowles. Okay, I play Holly, the new waitress at Merlot's on HBO's True Blood, right? Well, let me just break this down for you, okay? I would rather spend all night with them damn bloodsuckers than another minute listening to Mr. Media Radio. No thanks.